Well, hello everyone. Welcome to our Friday webinar. I am Dr. Tina Johnson, and with me is Dr. Chris Morris. Combined, we have over 65 years of experience working with natural health and holistic supplements. And our focus is not disease. Our focus is restoring the body. And those two things cannot coexist in the body. You either have health or disease. And today's topic is going to be a little controversial. I don't understand why, when you start to see the data, you're going to, it doesn't need to be controversial. So Dr. Chris, welcome. I'm excited about this topic. How about you?
Yes. Good morning, Dr. Tina, and welcome everyone. Thanks for joining us. And it is a great topic. And again, it's part of our just educational process of helping you understand that talking about how the body works, how nature works, not how we deal with symptoms or deal with, diseases. We're talking about health. So let's get started. And great topic here, Dr. Tina.
Yes. And I want to mention today's webinar is for informational purposes only. We are not here to be your doctors. We are not here to tell you to stop taking prescriptions. We are here to inform you of some of the statistics and the data surrounding today's topic. Big topic, cholesterol. You know, cholesterol, unfortunately, has gotten a bad rap. Again, it's controversial. I remember when we were told, do not eat eggs. It gives you bad cholesterol. Do not eat butter. It's bad for you. And they came out with that plastic stuff called margarine, which is worse for you. You know, and we saw such a yo-yo effect, a roller coaster yo-yo effect that was happening with people and their health in this country. And cholesterol is one of the most important lipids in the body. It's a fat. Lipids are fats. And its primary role is to regulate the phospholipid bilayer structure. You've heard us talk about phospholipids. All right. It regulates that layer structure of all the membranes in the body. And when we talk about membranes in the body, it's all of the membranes, whether it's your lungs, you know, the brain, whether it's, any tissue in the body has these membranes. Well, the cells have a lot of membranes, and cholesterol is extremely important for managing and balancing the membrane fluids and the structure. So cholesterol, when you hear cholesterol, we want you to think good things. We don't want you to think bad things. So let's go ahead and look at the cross section of a cell. We've talked
let me share a little bit though, sure. Dr. Tina, on just the emphasis, because the major focus of the medical profession for over 40 years now, or last four decades. And they're taught to fear cholesterol. And that's really just such misinformation. There's no cause and effect relationship that has been established. So let's get into the specifics to understand that. Thank you, Dr. Tina.
Yeah, thanks for adding that. You know, it's a very fear-driven system. So yeah, just keep in mind, you know, I want to just bring up one other thing about cholesterol. Think about cholesterol as well. It changes on a daily basis. So when you go in and you have a cholesterol panel done, just know it's a snapshot in that moment. So let's say that you have a cut or a wound. You're going to have more cholesterol circulating in the bloodstream because it helps to go heal those wounds. So we'll get into some of those dynamics. So again, I mentioned the phospholipid layer, and, you know, cholesterol helps to manage and balance that phospholipid layer. And when we're talking about the phospholipid layer, Telomega delivers this phospholipid layer. It builds this phospholipid layer. Those fats are needed for rebuilding this. So our telomega, along with cholesterol, works at the very cellular level. Okay, so we need those. They work very synergistically together. Dr. Chris, do you want to add?
No, let's jump to the next slide and then just really get into some of the controversy here, because as Dr. Tina was mentioning, the bulk of cholesterol is circulating and it's made by the liver, not by the diet. Only, it's what, 75%, 75 to 85% of the cholesterol is synthesized by and made by the liver. And about 20 to 25% is what comes from what we consume dietarily. So there's the good fatty acid, phosphatidylcholine, is transferred to make cholesterol. So we're giving our good telomere to our liver and helping it actually to make the good fats, you know, to do things that the body needs. And so here's a real key component here, is that cholesterol is packaged along with triglycerides. And this is what makes the LDL, the low density lipoproteins, which is supposedly the bad guy. But remember, it's the triglycerides that make it. And we keep talking about triglycerides. They're appropriate, but they're usually over-absorbed, over-consumed. And why? It's because of sugar. So let's talk about sugar. Let's don't talk about cholesterol. Let's talk about what's causing the problem for the LDL that's raising here. So the LDL is just part of the circulatory function of cholesterol, and it's necessary. So all body cells have LDL receptors. So why would the cells have the receptor if it's a bad thing? No, it's there and it's appropriate for transferring all the good fats that we need to build the surface layers that we talk about. So you see, the ratio is important, the HDL to LDL, but then we lose that ratio because of diet, because of the sugars, because of the stressors that we go through to create that. So we help the good fats with the telomega. We help with the right types of a lifestyle approach. And now you're correcting these issues rather than trying to deal with a symptom, right, Dr. Tina? We're going after the symptom of the LDL rather than the reason for it.
Exactly. And so you mentioned sugars and the triglycerides. And, you know, changing your diet is one thing, but also increasing your exercise is going to help burn up some of those stored triglycerides in the body as well. So when we look at cholesterol overall, the ratio HDL, LDL is important, but total cholesterol is something that we're going to take a peek at as well. And here's what the medical system says. And beware, just beware. They're saying healthy cholesterol levels, total. And this is what we're going to look at today. We're just going to go into the total. Without getting into too much detail, it says total 200 and or less are healthy levels of cholesterol. Well, you are going to clearly see today that that is not correct. And what's driving a lot of these other diseases, such as dementia, Alzheimer's, you know, other mortality rates are going up because of this lower level of cholesterol that they're pushing. They're saying at risk is 200 to 239 total cholesterol, and dangerous levels are above 240. Please make a mental note, write this down, take a picture. You're going to totally see what the studies are clearly showing, how cholesterol is affecting our health. So here's a study. This was done in 2019. You can find it on PubMed, go find it yourself, and just type this into Google, total cholesterol and all-cause mortality. What do we mean by that? All-cause mortality, death rates. And there's a study that was done by sex and age, and it's 12.8 million adults that were studied over years. And that's a pretty good number. So you can imagine the accuracy that's coming with that. Dr. Chris, do you want to add anything before I jump into some of these numbers?
Oh, let's do the numbers.
So we're looking at total cholesterol here for all participants, all ages, all participants. And I want you to clearly see that all-cause mortality rates start to go up at 200 or less. Total cholesterol. Okay. Clearly, lower levels of cholesterol are far more dangerous than high levels of cholesterol. Look at 280 compared to 170, right around 170. Okay, they're about the same. So when we're looking at good cholesterol, if you are anywhere near 200, what does the medical system do? They go, you're healthy, but based on your age, based on your genetics, based on, you know, probably what's going to happen within 10 years, you're going to have a stroke or heart attack. We're going to go ahead and put you on a statin drug to try to prevent some kind of potential cardiovascular risk. And so what they're doing is they're putting people on statin drugs around this level, driving your total cholesterol down, creating more issues with all-cause mortality rates versus if you were to keep at a normal pace and even go up to 280 in cholesterol. And here over on the right, we just divided men and women, and there's not much difference, okay, for all-cause mortality. Men, a little bit higher with lower rates of cholesterol, okay? Dr. Chris, anything to add here?
To emphasize in our introduction that we said there's no cause-effect relationship between heart disease. So that's really important to understand that.
Exactly. Yes. And so look at what are the healthy levels? 200 to 260 on average. 200, 260 on average, right in that range. This is just overall between the 12.8 million all age groups, men and women. All right. Now let's break it down a little bit more. When we're looking at overall age groups, you see 45 to 54 years old, you know, we've got, again, better to have cholesterol be right around the 200 to 240 range. Okay. When you move to 55 to 64 years old, look at this. Look at how all-cause mortality rates spike for a 35 to 44-year-old male if their cholesterol is too low. Okay. And you start to see, you know, this breakdown, it's just so much better to have 200 to 240. Jumping into 65 to 74 year olds, look at how it changes from when you're 18 to 34 into 65 to 74 year olds. We need that cholesterol. We need to have it, that good cholesterol, all of it, the total cholesterol, anywhere from 240 to 280. Look at the numbers. They're clear. 75 to 99 year olds. Now, when you start getting to 200, mortality rates, all-cause mortality rates start to go up. So now you're looking at 220 to 280. Okay. And we show you that they're saying if you are 200 or under, we're going to give you a drug to lower your overall cholesterol, your total cholesterol, right? And why is this happening? I mean, I think we all know why this is happening, but you need to see, they're saying dangerous levels above 240. Maybe if you're young, sure, but you need to take a look at that study. You can all go grab those numbers. You can all take a look at more detail. that is out there on the internet for you on PubMed, okay? Nothing to be controversial about. The data is clear. And that was just one study. There are many, many, many studies out there that show and reflect that, okay? Dr. Chris, anything to add?
No, just to let's emphasize again what's happening with the conventional approach. So through the years, the American Heart Association, again, to trying to just focus on heart disease, which doesn't apply here, is that total cholesterol levels be less than 200, right? Just like the we're trying to show you in the statistics. So the cholesterol levels cannot determine heart disease risk unless they're above 330, not 200 less. So in 2004, the American Heart Association started to even change their guidelines and make things even worse. So there's no way, you know, to reach these ridiculous low numbers that they're trying to make you do, get below 200, you know, 200 or below, without taking a drug. And when you take the drug, here's what you need to know. Because in some cases, the drug is appropriate, but it's a small fraction, not a major fraction. It's not like 60 to 70% that need it that's being prescribed now. It's more like, you know, 10 to 15% because they have a specific condition with handling fats in their body. It's a liver issue. It's not a cholesterol issue. So when you start taking these meds, these, you know, statin drugs, they actually can increase your risk to heart disease because they deplete the body of its energy components. One of the things that you lose when you take a statin drug is CoQ10. CoQ10 is how your body makes energy. Well, they've discovered that and said, well, we'll start prescribing that as a supplement. But then there's so many complexities to the body and just understanding just one component like CoQ10. So it's important that they see the problem and they try to address it. But the real problem is don't create it in the first place. So here's some of the side effects that when you lose that energy component that happens with the statins: weakness, muscle aches, cancer risk increases, immune system suppression, you know, serious degenerative muscle tissue conditions, potential increase of liver enzymes. So again, liver function is so important to everything in the body, and we start compromising that. And then we look at the blood work and see some of these symptoms, we start recommending other drugs that was caused by a drug in the first place that it wasn't needed. So again, I just hate to get off the soapbox here, Dr. Tina, but
that's all right.
Really have to get real. Go ahead.
Yeah, and you know, and here's the thing, they will push fear on you. I was just at the doctor with a family member yesterday, and the fear, and telling you, it's the only way. You have to become your own health advocate. So the use of statin cholesterol lowering meds has been on the rise for decades, okay? Decades, and they're among the most widely used drugs in the world. Get this, people. In the U.S., close to 50% of U.S. adults over the age of 75 are taking a statin to lower their overall total cholesterol in the misguided hope of preventing heart disease, heart attacks, and stroke. It does not do that, and it causes more things, more issues, like Dr. Chris mentioned.
So double the risk of dementia, which we're seeing gets growing out of control, lower cholesterol considered marker for Alzheimer's. And we understand, again, Alzheimer's was shown to be, again, a symptom condition that can be changed because of, you know, working with the liver and the diet. And then double or triple diabetes risk. And all the things that we're seeing naturally happen in our culture, is also, there's a direct correlation, I feel. And again, this is something that really needs to be studied, but intuitively I'm saying that as everybody starts taking more and more of these, you know, statin drugs, they're looking at the side effects that the statins cause, and we're seeing it right here as the increase.
Yeah, just a moment here. Yeah, and when we're looking at diabetes, double or triple the diabetes risk if you're on a statin drug, it's because of hyperglycemia and insulin resistance that starts to happen. And research has been done on this. So in the Netherlands, they did they analyzed data of more than 9,500 patients. Those who have used statins had a 38% higher risk of type 2 diabetes. I mean, the data is there. And so just be aware, all right? And increased death risk from COVID-19. That is from patients that have had, among patients with type 2 diabetes admitted to a hospital for COVID-19, those that were taking statins had significantly higher mortality rates from COVID-19 within 7 days and 28 days compared to those not taking the drugs. And then when we're looking at lower cholesterol levels are associated with cognitive function. Okay, think about it. Your brain needs cholesterol. 25 to 30% of your body's total cholesterol is found in your brain. Okay, it helps to develop and maintain the plasticity and the function of your neurons. It plays an important role in the synthesis, the transportation, the metabolism of steroidal hormones and fat-soluble vitamins. You need the cholesterol as a transport system for all of the other good nutrients that your body needs. So we just want you to be aware of the statin scam, you know, that's going on. And we just have to say it, okay? If you reduce your cholesterol to those dangerous levels, you will have issues with other areas, and it doesn't necessarily contribute to helping reduce the risk of cardiovascular disease. Okay. Dr. Chris?
Yeah, let's just real quick, just run out some of the solutions. You know, good animal-based omega-3 fats. So we're talking like Telo Omega, right? So fish oils are so important out there, but let's take the best type of omega-3 fats with the krill that we get in our Telo Omega. Eliminate grains and sugar from your daily diet. You know, you hear us talk about lifestyle that way all the time. It's about good fruits and vegetables. You know, and healthy raw fats. So butter, cream, yogurt, cheese, avocados, raw nuts, seeds, eggs, all the things that we're trying to restrict.
Right? Fatty fish. Oh my gosh. Well, fatty fish is amazing. Yes. Salmon.
Eliminate the bad stuff like the smoking and the drinking and exercise daily. Exercise, exercise, exercise. And of course, our emotional issues, you know, reducing the stress. And here's where our TeloYouth helps us so much to handle stress so that we can really get into that Zen cycle and getting into good sleep and good rest and then the ability to not create all the inflammatory conditions that, you know, get projected out there for the cholesterol.
Exactly.
Should we wrap it up here a little bit?
Yeah, just remember the habits that got you there in the first place are the habits you need to change going forward. And that will, I mean, the body can restore health. And you can do that very effectively and much quicker with TeloYouth and TeloMega and changing your diet and lifestyle.